this entire proceeding is ended.
With that gavel, Chairman Joseph Biden ended three of the most remarkable days in the history of the Congress. Senators investigating allegations of unwanted sexual advances by a Supreme Court nominee had waded out into uncharted and often seamy waters, hoping to arrive at the truth. But when the hearings ended at 2 o'clock this morning, 33 hours and 22 witnesses after they began, the Senate was right back where it started, having to weigh his word against hers. Anita Hill, a University of Oklahoma law professor, worked for Clarence Thomas during the early 1980s at the Department of Education and at the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission. She appeared before the Senate Judiciary Committee to tell her story.
His conversations were very vivid. He spoke about acts that he had seen in pornographic films involving such matters as women having sex with animals and films showing group sex or rape scenes. He talked about pornographic materials depicting individuals with large penises or large breasts involved in various sex acts. On several occasions, Thomas told me graphically of his own sexual prowess. Because I was extremely uncomfortable talking about sex with him at all, and particularly in such a graphic way, I told him that I did not want to talk about these subjects.
Judge Clarence Thomas had appeared to be within days of confirmation to the Supreme Court when the Anita Hill story broke. Now he was forced to return to the Judiciary Committee to defend himself, and did so with a blistering attack against his accuser, his opponents, and against the committee itself.
I would like to start by saying unequivocally, uncategorically, that I deny each and every single allegation against me today that suggested in any way that I had conversations of a sexual nature or about pornographic material with Anita Hill, that I ever attempted to date her, that I ever had any personal sexual interest in her, or that I in any way ever harassed her. A second, and I think more important point, I think that this today is a travesty. It's a national disgrace. And from my standpoint, as a black American, as far as I'm concerned, it is a high-tech lynching for uppity blacks who in any way deign to think for themselves, to do for themselves, to have different ideas. And it is a message that unless you kowtow to an old order, this is what will happen to you. You will be lynched, destroyed, caricatured by a committee of the U.S. Senate rather than hung from a tree.
Thomas continued to lash out throughout his testimony. When he concluded Saturday evening, Committee Chairman Joseph Biden lashed back.
I'm getting fed up with this stuff about how terrible this system is. I hear everybody talk about how terrible the primary system is. We're big boys. I knew when I ran for president, everything was free game. Anybody who runs for the Supreme Court or is appointed to the Supreme Court, to be more precise, should understand. It's not Boy Scouts, it's not Cub Scouts. In the case of the president, it's for the right to be leader of the free world, and no one ever said it would be easy. And whoever goes in the Supreme Court is going to determine the fate of this country more than anybody. For the next 20 years, we're going to have people, scrupulous and unscrupulous, respond and react. So, Judge, this is less directed at you than it is to my pontificating colleagues, Democrat and Republican alike. So, Judge, I have not made my judgment based upon this proceeding because we have not heard all the evidence.
Most members of the Judiciary Committee came away from the first 2 days of hearings agreeing on one thing. Both Hill and Thomas were credible witnesses, their testimonies powerfully convincing. The senator's hope was that the truth could be found somewhere among the 20 supporting witnesses who testified on Sunday. The rare Sunday session began with a panel of four, each saying it was years ago that they independently learned of Anita Hill's problems with Clarence Thomas.
In the fall of 1982, Professor Hill shared with me in confidence the fact that she considered Judge Thomas's behavior toward her in the office to be inappropriate. Professor Hill did not at that time, nor in subsequent conversations, provide exact details about the action she found inappropriate conduct. She did tell me they were sexual in nature.
She told me that she was being subjected to sexual harassment from her boss, to whom she referred by name. That boss was Clarence Thomas.
A second panel of four, each having worked with Thomas and Hill at the EEOC, called the allegations preposterous and searched in vain for a motive behind Hill's accusations.
Everyone who knows Clarence knows that he is a very proud and dignified man. With his immediate staff, he's very warm and friendly, sort of like a friend or a father. You could talk with him about your problems, go to him for advice, but like a father, he commanded and he demanded respect.
What do you think, Ms. Holt? I think you know her the best of anybody on the panel. You think it is conceivable that Professor Hill might really think this happened when it didn't?
I think that's the only conceivable answer, Senator. I do not believe it happened.
In addition to the testimony, it was revealed that on Sunday, Anita Hill took and passed a lie detector test, according to the polygraph expert who administered it.
It was my opinion that there was no indication of deception to any of those relevant questions.
Under pressure from Republicans on the committee, however, Chairman Biden called the test inconclusive and announced the results would not be placed in the record.
If we get to the point in this country where lie detector tests are the basis upon which we make judgments and insist upon people having them, and by inference of those who don't have them that they did something wrong, we have reached a sad day for the civil liberties of this country.
It will be up to each member of the Senate to decide whether the test carries any weight with them. The vote on Clarence Thomas's nomination to the Supreme Court is set for 6 o'clock tomorrow evening.